Hello everyone. Hope you're keeping well at this time. Welcome to session 21 on wave reflection from berm breakwaters. I'm Kartika, lecturer in engineering at Charles Sturt University, New South Wales, Australia. I have the pleasure in welcoming you all to this session along with my colleagues in this study, Dr. Amir from Griffith University and Professor Charles from University of Canberra. As many of you would be aware, breakwater structures are used to reduce the wave action at the lee side of the structure and to protect the coastal areas from the action of waves. Berm breakwater is a type of coastal structure which has the presence of a berm at or above the still water level. These are not new structures, and berm breakwaters have been constructed as early as 19th century. Australia played an important role in the development of berm breakwaters, with many innovative structures being built in the 1970s and early 1980s. This ranges from the berm breakwater at Port Elliot in South Australia, where quarried rock were dumped into the sea and allowed to take its own natural slope, to a more recent berm breakwater at Hay Point in Queensland, wherein quarry investigations were made and a mass armoured berm breakwater was built in an initially unstable form, but with sufficient material provided to allow natural forces to modify its shape to a stable profile. As you might have guessed from the explanation given, berm breakwater has the advantage that locally available rock materials can be used for the construction. This avoids the use of concrete armor units in the design, and it in turn minimizes the use of heavy and expensive construction equipments. This in turn leads to considerable cost savings. The important governing parameters in the design of berm breakwater are stability and crest height to minimize the recession and the wave overtopping. Wave reflection, though it follows the other parameters in terms of priority, it can hinder the ship navigation and cause erosion, especially at the berm breakwater head. This assumes importance when the berm breakwater protects very important structures, such as the one at Hammerfest, where it protects an LNG plant at the lee side. The image shows the intensity of wave reflection and how severe it can be, especially during a storm. The figure shows the cross-section of a berm breakwater and the major hydraulic performance factors affecting the design, such as overtopping, wave reflection, and run-up. As you can see from the figure, the interaction of reflected waves with the structure and the incident wave can affect the stability and design performance of the berm breakwater itself. This slide shows the structural and hydraulic governing parameters that affect the wave reflection from berm breakwaters. Wave parameters such as the significant spectral wave height, spectral wave length, and structural parameters such as berm width, berm level, structure slope above and below the berm, and rock size are the major ones that govern the wave reflection from the structure. In terms of estimating the wave reflection, we can use the empirical formulas developed from small-scale experimental data and often validated on large-scale or field measurements. Another option, which is more recent and available with the advanced computing facilities, is the ANN models. In this study, the focus has been on the empirical formulas, as they are usually preferred by engineers to understand the physical significance of governing parameters on wave reflection during the design of the structure. One of the earliest formulas for estimating the wave reflection from coastal structure is that of POSMA in 1989. It was developed for straight sloped rubble mound breakwaters with cot alpha ranging from 1.5 to 6 with core materials of varying permeability. Much later in 2000, Ali Khani suggested a formula for reshaped berm breakwaters with slopes between 4 and 5, relating the wave reflection with wave steepness. In 2008, Zanotti and Vandermeer suggested that the slope below the berm is important in estimating the wave reflection from berm breakwaters, and suggested this formula, which is shown here. Slopes in the run-up and run-down levels are estimated based on the position of the berm and incorporated into the Iribarren number to represent the influence on wave reflection. More recently, Vandermeer and Sigdarsen in 2016 suggested a formula that takes into account the effect of reshaping in addition to wave steepness. As seen, Most formulas correlate the wave reflection with Iribarren number, which is the ratio of the slope of the structure to the wave steepness. And some of the latest ones, such as Zanotti and Vandermeer 2008 or Vandermeer and Sigdarsen 2016, which are developed from a database consisting of berm breakwater data, incorporate the effects of berm and reshaping in the estimation of wave reflection. As mentioned before, the empirical formulas are developed from small-scale experiment data, and currently the data on berm breakwaters are mostly from the research of Leek Anderson, Myhra, and Sven Botson. These data represent cross-sections with slopes in the range 1.25 to 3. However, only 10% of the existing wave reflection data represent berm breakwaters with an initial slope of 1:1.5. This slope is important as this is the suggested slope for hardly or partly reshaping berm breakwater structures, which are designed and preferred lately due to its reshaping characteristics being more predictable and designable. In order to fill the gaps in the existing database, laboratory tests were conducted in the wave flume at the hydraulics laboratory of Griffith University. The flume had a length of 18 meter, width of 0.45 meter, and a depth of 0.8 meter. 53 tests were conducted over a range of wave steepness from 0.02 representing wind conditions to 0.06 representing swell conditions. A wide range of structural and hydraulic conditions were tested for the 1:1.5 slope. For example, the tested range of wave reflections were from 0.3 to 0.6, whereas the existing ones were between 0.2 to 0.3. And another example would be the existing berm width tested were mostly around 0.3 meter, whereas in this study, a wider range of 0.25 to 0.45 meters were tested. Existing data of wave reflection from berm breakwaters were obtained from the updated CLASH database. It was around 162 measured small-scale wave reflection, and the data developed in this study were plotted against the estimations from existing formulas. It can be seen that the Vandermeer and Sigdarsen formula, developed from berm breakwater data, estimates quite well the new data, though there is scatter and some underestimations. The Zanotti and Vandermeer formula estimations have considerable scatter, and this is in line with the observations for emerged berm cases mentioned in their study. The data in this study is mostly with emerged berms, as it is commonly encountered in practical designs. The older formulas were developed from limited or no data on berm breakwater, obviously shows a large scatter, and it can be seen that wave reflections are underestimated, which can be dangerous in terms of affecting the overall performance of the structure. To compare the measurements and estimations quantitatively, the statistical measures of root mean square error, discrepancy ratio, and bias were used. If the formula or model estimates the measurements well, RMSE should be close to 0, DR should be close to 1, and bias should be close to 0. From the table, we can see that the Vandermeer and Sigdarsen formula works best with the lowest RMSE, a DR close to 1, and a low bias. Also, all the formulas are currently underestimating the wave reflection from berm breakwaters. At the moment, our team is working on improving the formula in terms of representing the governing parameters that influence wave reflection. As it can be seen, there exists a large scatter with certain parameters like the dimensionless crest freeboard, the slope including the berm, and also the wave steepness, proper representation of which can lead to a more robust formula. To conclude, in this study, existing overtopping database was extended with the data on hardly or partly reshaping berm breakwaters with an initial slope of 1.5. Available empirical models show scatter, predominantly underestimating the wave reflection from berm breakwaters. Data from this study could be used to improve the existing prediction formulas. Thank you for your attention and have a great day.